Yeah, now curious, what exactly, which story do I am I supposed to tell you about Mauthausen, isn't it? There were concentration camps in the region. So what does that topic mean for people now here living in the region? There are these two groups, and therefore it was also a very delicate atmosphere in the region, because you have this pretty polarized opinions, the ones who say we don't want to talk about it anymore, and others who say let's start with it in a different way of talking.
I'm curious about any memories that you have, because you facilitated these actual wisdom councils, yes. So now from the bird's eye view to kind of zooming in the wisdom council itself, do you have any memorable moments or anything that happened during the facilitation itself that you might want to mention?
Jim, you taught us that any topic is possible to facilitate with DF, and even if it's really a dragon problem and a dragon topic, you know. And we were entering this room, and we were quite aware that perhaps dragon topics will come up. You know, there was this man, he started talking about foreigners, you know. And we have much too much foreigners in Austria, and they cost us much money, and all this, you know. And then, as I remembered well how you, Jim, did it when topics came up like this, you know. And I said, I'm really curious to hear more about it, why I hear this concern, and I want to hear more about it. And you really could, I experienced how mindful this is, because this person was completely stunned about that, because the normal reaction is slap him verbally in the face and he stands up and steps out, you know, and doesn't come back. And he afterwards, the second day, he told me that he wanted to say the truth and then go out, you know, because he was expecting that we all will slap him. And as the political correct persons, you know. And then and this was really a special moment for all of us when he then started to talk about his daughter, who is without a job for 3 years, and he has the impression that all people find the foreigners who come to Austria, they all get jobs, but his daughter not, and so on. So then there was a complete shift in the room, you know, because he was experienced differently. People could connect with him. With his concerns and anxieties and so on. And also others in the room, for example, a 15-year-old girl, she said, but isn't that the same when we talk about foreigners? Isn't that the same as it was in the Nazi time, when they were telling these things about Jews and so on? And there was a completely different atmosphere in the room, you know. And he could listen to others, and the others could listen to him. And then, he stayed and came the next day and talked with us. And for me, it was also, you know, I was concerned also when we did the first Wisdom Council, because there was so much, as I told you, the mayors and also the project leader, they said, I don't know if this is really the right format for this case, you know. And also we talked with the two guys who were from the region living here in Vienna, and they said that it's really a conflictive atmosphere, and who you dare going there and talk about that. You have to be aware that there will be a hot atmosphere in the room. And for me also, it was this moment, this was the moment where I knew now nothing can happen anymore, you know. And we went with a completely different, we were completely relaxed and knew that we were looking forward to the next ones, you know, because we really experienced that wonderful moments where people understand each other, and we had 15-year-old and 80-year-old in the room, you know, and all of them, they said, this was so great to hear these young people. The old ones said, to hear these young people. We didn't know that the young ones, they know so much about this time, and we didn't know that they are interested in that, you know. And the younger ones, they said, we had so great two 15-year-old girls, and they said, it was the greatest experience in our life to sit with grown-ups, you know, because to sit with old people. Normally, when we talk with old people, these are our grandparents, and what do we talk about them, you know? But here we sit with old people, and they are listening to us. You know, they are listening what we are thinking. They are interested in that. And this was so great to hear all that, what they are telling us about their experiences from this time. And so this deep listening, you know, that was also something very, very special that made the participants so grateful that they had this time to understand, to really listening to each other. Yeah. So I'm so convinced also from this selection by random, you know, because then you have really so different people in the room, you know. And many people, they say, I just put it away when I wrote read this invitation. I put it away and said, oh no, I don't go there because I cannot contribute, you know. I'm not an interesting person. I cannot contribute. And then the husband or the daughter, I don't know, said, just go there and listen a little bit. And if you don't like it, then just go out, you know. And nobody went out. But there you can see that this random selection really reaches people who wouldn't come to a participatory process, which is an open invitation. And as we had this special atmosphere of attention and respect, it was possible to talk about things like this, where people also said that they are sorry that they didn't have the courage to do it differently. and yeah, tears.
Wow.
Your one benefit that I had never thought of before, and that you're kind of expressing now, it seems to me, Martina, is just this opportunity that it hands people to say that I regret that I didn't act and I'm sorry. I mean, it's a way of them coming to terms with themselves is really what is happening. They have an opportunity to somehow say to the world, which that they've always wanted to say, but there's no opportunity to do that. So there was something in the moment that you created a space for them to do that. And I think that's absolutely beautiful.
They said things they wouldn't have said in another context. And that was the most beautiful thing, you know? And that was even when I talk about it, I get little, how do you say,
goosebumps.
Yeah, because it was so moving, you know, and we were with tears, all of us. One participant put it like this. She said, "Now, for the first time, I have the impression that healing can start. That this was the starting point for something new." Yeah, I was in Mauthausen last autumn because they organized a human rights symposium. And this was one of the results or effects, or how do they say, of this process.